Alright, about to start test number three. Set up a large test. We're at 10 watts. Didn't look like the tuner is having to do too much. Going into an off-center fed dipole outside. And here we go. Testing this heat sink here. Usually get the warning at 63. And then it will back down to 5 watts. At this point we've sent more data than you typically send at one time. By this point you'd usually be receiving. So this is not normal operating. It's the first time I've seen it actually go down in temperature. Now it's going back up. And we're at 62, 63, high temp right there at that time. Let's see if it's, yep, back down to 5 watts. Still a high temp alarm. And we are sending way more data at this point than would usually be considered appropriate. In my last test, this would just keep going and going. It wouldn't ever turn off, as in never would become a problem. I'm just curious. I put this down to 3 watts. What would the power do? Yeah, it goes way down. Three watts is more efficient. when you see high temp, it's going back down to 5 watts. Still transmitting. What if we don't go down all the way to 3 watts? It doesn't seem to really matter. Stop transmitting. Of course, part of the heat sink is how fast will it lose and shed heat. That's pretty warm. Sure, if I had a fan blowing on it, it would go a lot quicker, but that's kind of the whole point, is I don't want to use any power to shed heat. I just want to improve on this, because that is just not much of a heat sink, really. First attempt, definitely do better the second time. I'm trying to think, should I put deeper grooves, thinner fins, all things to consider. Alright, I'm going to end this test for now. The next one, I believe, I'll try with, I'll put the original heatsink on and see how it goes.